High Tides. I hope you're having a stressless test week. Last Sunday was the 88th annual Oscars, and it was full of surprises.
I have to thank everyone from the very onset of my career, Mr. Caton Jones, for casting me in my first film, Mr. Scorsese, for teaching me so much about the cinematic art form.
The 88th annual Oscars were just last Sunday, where milestones were reached. Leonardo DiCaprio finally won an Oscar for his brilliant acting in The Revenant. Strong issues such as sexism and specifically rape victims were talked about. And the old elephant in the room was finally center stage.
I'm here at the Academy Awards, otherwise known as the White People's Choice Awards.
Racism in Hollywood.
If they not-
The controversy began when this year's Oscar nominations didn't have a single person of color nominated for acting. This led to the popularization of the hashtag #OscarSoWhite. And the boycotting of Jada Pinkett Smith and Spike Lee. But the lack of diversity is not just present in this year's Oscars, but throughout history. In fact, 6.4% of acting nominations of the total of 1,668 since the awards began in 1929 have gone to non-white actors. And for the past 25 years, only 56 of the actors were non-white. The Academy itself has been shown to be 94% Caucasian and 77% male. So when the Academy itself is so lacking of color, can you really expect the nominations to be so different? But the matter of racism in Hollywood makes you question whether it's really about the lack of diversity in nominations, or maybe the lack of diversity in casting of actors. The characters being written, and the stories being told.
Very special, thank you.
This is one of the happiest moments of my life. And I want to thank each one of you who had a part in selecting me for one of the awards.
Thanks, Parvati. It sure was a glitzy night. So our ESOL program got to go on an amazing experience, and they got to travel to the Florida's capital.
So my name is Ms. Geraldo, and I teach ESOL level 1 and level 2. The trip was very interesting. It was the first time I've been to a trip like this. And it was interesting to see how the kids reacted, how they responded to. It was also exhausting. The trip was about teaching the kids how the government in the United States work, making policies, putting out proposals. It also included trips to the university. They had to go and see, and it was interesting because they learned about them. They went to the location, and also the time that we went to the Capitol. That was interesting because we got to vote for issues and see how the process worked when Congress and Senate are voting for a policy. That they were all interesting proposals because there were issues that are current, and it shows that the youth, the young people, are interested in these topics. So like the part when they talked about legalizing marijuana. The legalization of marijuana for everybody did not pass, but when the kid brought it under the medical field, the proposal was passed. So it's interesting to see how the kids are in tune with what's going on. And sometimes it doesn't seem in the class, but they are. We visited FIU, and we did that a week before because FIU is in Miami. We visited the Central Florida State, we visit Florida University, and we visit Florida State University.
Looks like an interesting trip. Did you know that this summer Brazil is hosting the Olympics? Where did the Olympics even come from?
According to historical records, the first ancient Olympic Games can be traced back to 776 BC. They were dedicated to the Olympian gods and were staged on the ancient plains of Olympia. The modern Olympic Games are the leading international sporting event, with more than 200 nations participating. They're held every 4 years with the Summer and Winter Games, but 2 years apart. As the decision-making body, the International Olympic Committee is responsible for picking the host city for each Games and funding the Games to the Olympic Charter. This year, the Summer Olympic Games will take place in Rio de Janeiro.
It sure is an historic event. Speaking of history, did you know that Beach High had its 19th annual carnival? It sure was an event you did not want to miss.
I want to thank the public today, Ms. Arslanian and the Brazilian Club for all their work in putting this all together. Thank you very much.
Marina, anfetamina. Marina, gasolina. Marina, caipirinha. Cha cha chica.
What does carnival mean?
A celebration of life.
A celebration.
Yeah.
I usually have carnivals around this time of the year because it's the start of 40 days before
Lent.
It's Brazilian things?
No.
Damn, you asked the wrong person, bro.
Well, I don't know what it means, but I know what it is.
Like, it's like a famous festival in Brazil that's celebrated like yearly.
Well, we're part of the Brazilian club.
Yeah, since we're in it, we basically have to produce the Brazilian carnival.
Well, I'm doing Miss Carnival and auxiliary flags, and she is
Mr. Carnival.
We're
Mr. Carnival.
Yeah, we're both over the Mr. Carnival at the moment.
We're dancing, and I'm holding numbers for the Mr. and Mrs. Carnival.
I'm working with stage crew with lights and stuff.
It's been fun.
Yeah, a lot of hard work.
Yeah. This production of today is really produced by students. And I'm so proud of them because some of them are not even Brazilians and they are taking pride in putting the show together for you guys. Are you guys having fun?
Yeah. Huh.
That's all for this week. High tides. I hope you have an amazing weekend.
Who is running for president? Donald Trump and
Donald Trump, Bernie Sanders, Hillary Clinton.
Okay. There's Hillary Clinton, Bernie Sanders, Donald Trump, Ben Carson, Jeb Bush. No, I don't think Bush is in it anymore.
Donald Trump.
Marco Rubio.
Okay, the presidential election is coming up really soon. I happen to be a registered Republican. I've got some very weird choices. I have to go for either maybe Cruz, Rubio, Trump.
Ted Cruz, Marco Rubio. Donald Trump, Marco Rubio, and Hillary Clinton. That's all I know.
Not Donald Trump.
Ben Carson's pretty strong, I think, in that realm. He's a retired neurosurgeon, so I think I might edge toward him.
Not Donald Trump.
Marco Rubio.
I'm going for Bernie Sanders.
And let's say I'm Marco Rubio.